Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Černý, and today I would like to talk to you about why you should use CAD when animating in 3ds Max. CAD, or Character Animation Toolkit, is a former plugin for 3ds Max which was integrated and built into 3ds Max since version 2010. So it's quite old, I know, but bear with me. I have been using CAD for over 5 years now, and we have used it in two different companies I worked for in full production for video games. It has most, if not all, of the features other softwares bring, and some features that even other softwares like Maya or MOTIONBUILDER don't have, like procedural animation for example. Unfortunately, CAD is not being updated very often, and is more or less the same as it was 5-6 years ago. You should keep this in mind, as this is likely to continue because it seems like even Autodesk doesn't realize how powerful animation tool they have. General consensus is that Maya is used more for animation because of its superior rigging and skinning tools, which is mostly true I would say. So if you want to do very complex custom rig with a lot of scripting involved, Maya would be probably the better option most of the time. However, I would say Maya lacks in an animation department compared to 3ds Max, especially because of CAD. But these software questions are quite polarizing and everybody likes something else. So by no means I'm saying that Maya is better or worse than 3ds Max or anything like that. I just decided to talk about CAD because in my opinion it's heavily underrated and underused system, and not being talked about very often. Let's mention MOTIONBUILDER as well real quick, because it belongs here. But it's kind of a specific software because it focuses mainly on motion capture and therefore humanoids. So if you have anything to do with motion capture, use MOTIONBUILDER by all means. But if you want to do quadruped animals or something different than humanoid, you shouldn't do it in MOTIONBUILDER, as you basically lose all the advantages it brings. But let's get back to CAD. So what makes it so powerful? Well, first thing, you can do rigs in a matter of minutes. You can do basic rig for example this wolf in a matter of few minutes, and you have everything you need for an in-game character. But let's not just stop there. You can do birds, elephant, dragon, octopus. You can do weapons, facial rigs. You can basically really do almost anything. And if you get to some limitations of CAD and for some reason need to use regular bones, you can still create a hybrid rig with regular bones linked to the CAD bones, add them as a rigging component and keep all the advantages of CAD. Second thing, saving and loading clips. So let's say you have done your animation for this deer, but now you have a model of a goat and it needs a similar animation as you have done before, but you don't want to start from scratch. So what do you do? Well, you go and save your clip. Open up your goat model and load it on it. And as you can see, the animation plays just fine. Of course you will have to do some adjustments and fixing, but you have a base to start from. It works even when the deer rig didn't have all the bones the goat has, like udder or beard. But let's try even more extreme example. Let's load the same clip on a pigeon. And you will get this. Which looks completely broken, I know, but let's have a closer look. You see, pigeon has only two legs, and the front legs of a deer are now his wings. So let's just disable wings for a while to show you what we got. And you see, we have the same animation working just fine. Animation of a deer on a two-legged pigeon. A bird. I can't even tell you how powerful this is. Third, procedural animation. And this is a big one. You won't find anything like this in Maya or MOTIONBUILDER, or even most of the other softwares. Let's open up our goat again, and let's create a motion layer, which is CAD's layer for procedural animation. You will get some kind of a walk cycle right off the bat, however it looks terrible of course. But let's open up an edit panel. Don't be fooled by this window. It looks awful, cannot be scaled, isn't user friendly at all, but it gets the work done. So procedural animation means that you animate by changing parameters, not by keyframing. As you can see, you have a lot of parameters for each bone or hub in the rig, and by changing these values, animation changes. After a while, you might end up with something like this. And it's all done just by changing values, not a single keyframe was set. But it's not just walks, you can do trot, or run, or basically any cycled movement. And let's get to fourth and final thing for this video, which would be that by using CAD, you don't actually lose anything, which is arguably the best thing. You still animate just as you would with the regular bones or biped or any other system, but you get a lot of new functionality that you wouldn't have other way. Just a little advice, if you are interested in CAD and never done rigging with regular bones or biped, you shouldn't worry. You can jump straight into CAD and skip the others, even the absolute beginners. Because, well, most of the stuff can be done by CAD alone, and you don't need to know how exactly those other systems work. You can learn everything with CAD system. I am Miloš Černý, and thank you for watching. Just one more thing, this is my first commentary video ever, and as I don't even know if there is any audience for this kind of stuff, any like, comment or subscription is highly appreciated, as for me it is the only indicator that there is an interest in videos like this, and a motivation to do more of them. Anything helps really. Thank you.